अगेन दिस इज हरिवा प्रसाद दामर्ला इन कंटिन्यूएशन टू आवर डिस्कशन इन पार्ट वन ऑन डिजिटल स्विचिंग वी विल डिस्कस द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ डिजिटल स्विचिंग इन दिस सेशन इन अर्लियर सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ space switching. Now we will continue our discussion on space switching with an illustration. So as already we were discussing in part one, we have a switching matrix of n rows in the form of incoming highways, PCM highways, and n columns in the form of outgoing PCM highways. These are the input PCMs, these are the output PCMs. Now let us consider the transfer of a sample arriving in TS7 of incoming highway X1 to outgoing highway Y3. So we are considering, for explanation purpose, the information coming in TS7 on highway X1 is to be transferred to outgoing highway Y3. Since this is a space switch, there will be no reordering of time slot. That is, time slot interchange is not applicable in space switching, whereas in time switching, time slot interchange is a must. That is, the sample will be transferred without any time delay via the appropriate cross point. In other words, the objective is to transfer the contents of TS7 of highway X1 to TS7 of highway 3. So here our main objective is to transfer the contents of TS7 in incoming highway X1 to outgoing highway Y3 in the same time slot, that is on the same TS7. The time slot of incoming highway and outgoing highway remains the same since it is a space switch. The central control selects the control memory column corresponding to the output highway Y3. The central control selects the highway corresponding to the outgoing highway Y3. So this is the column. Okay. In this column, the memory location corresponding to the TS7 is chosen. So in this column also, the memory location corresponding to Y3 of TS7, this one is chosen. This is pertaining to time slot 7. Where we have to select? We have to select in the Y3 column. So this is the memory location. The address of the cross point is written in this location. This location contains the cross point or the AND gate through which the switching has to take place. That means the information or the address pertaining to this cross point, this one, whatever I am pointing, this is written here. That is, a binary 1 is written in location 7 as shown in figure 2. So here a binary 1 is written indicating that this cross point address which is to be operated, enabled for transfer of information from incoming highway to outgoing highway. This cross point remains operated for the duration of the time slot TS7 in each successive frame till the call loss. So this cross point is in operated mode for the duration of TS7. So the duration, we know it is for 3.9 microseconds. After 3.9 microseconds, it can be used for some other car. So in the next frame also, when TS7 appears, it will be operated for another 3.9 microseconds for transfer of information from this TS7 to this TS7. In the next successive also, it goes on like this till the end of the conversation or call completion. So it will be operated only for a duration of time slot 7, which is 3.9 microseconds and equal for all the 32 time slots. For disconnection of call, the central control erases the contents of the control memory locations corresponding to the concerned time slots. AND gates therefore are disabled and transfer of samples is halted. Once the call is completed and the call is to be disconnected, that means the interconnection between calling party and the call party is to be removed and the transfer of information is to be halted. For that, what happens? The central control arranges the memory location, the information available in the memory location. So the binary 1 will not be available in this location. Since binary 1 is not available for the input, one of the inputs of the AND gate, so this AND gate will be disabled. It will not be in operated condition. Once this is disabled, the information transfer from TS7 of X1 to TS7 of Y3 is halted. So that means the conversation is completed and calling party is free and called party is free, either for making a call or receiving a call. We will continue our discussion. So whatever we have discussed, the same thing here I am presenting in the form of a sequential operations. So first we will see the objective. The objective is to transfer the contents of TS7 of highway X1 to TS7 of highway 3. So our objective, once again I am reiterating that from here TS7 to this outgoing TS7, we have to transfer the information from X1 highway to Y3 highway. X1 highway is in incoming side and Y3 highway is in outgoing side. So in the same TS7, we have to transfer the information from this TS7 to this TS7. First operational sequence, number one, the central control selects control memory column 3 pertaining to Y3. This is the first action. So it has to select this column, Y3 column. This is pertaining to Y3 highway through AND gates. So it has to select this column. This is the column. Okay. In the column 3, memory location of TS7 is selected. In this column, okay, the TS7 location, the 7th location, this is TS0 location, TS1 location, and so on. This is TS7 location, and this is TS31 location. So we are interested in TS7 location. The address of the cross point is available in the memory location. So here, as we have already seen, the address of the cross point is written here in the form of binary 1. The cross point remains operated for the duration of the time slot 7 in each successive frame till the completion of the call. So this is in operate operational mode in successive frames of TS7 for a duration of 3.9 microsecond in each and every frame till the call completion. After call completion, for disconnection of the call, CC erases the contents of the control memory location 7 and the AND gate is disabled and the transfer samples is halted. Once the call is completed, then the connection is to be disconnected from calling party to called party. So the contents in this location are erased. The central control erases the contents here. Therefore, this AND gate will not be operated. So disabled. So therefore, the transfer of information from TS7X1 to TS7Y3 is halted. This is the sequence of operation as far as space switching is concerned. Now, we will discuss about the practical scenario of space switch. So, let us see both the drawing on the left as well as the contents in the right side. In a practical switch, the digital bits are transmitted in parallel rather than serially through the switching matrix. So in practical switching, the digital bits are transmitted in parallel mode. Here you are getting in serial mode. If you consider TS3, so there are 8 bits serially from bit 1 to bit 8. Similarly, in TS4 also bit 1 to bit 8. They are all coming in serial. On a single line they are coming. In the outgoing side, if you see, so with the help of serial to parallel converter, so it is nothing but a SIPO, serial input parallel output converter. So here it is, see, all the 8 bits of TS3, they are parallelly on 8 wires. Similarly, all the 8 bits are on 8 different wires parallelly. Here it is, input is serial, output is parallel. This is a practical switch. In serial, 32 time slots PCM multiplex, that is our 30 channel PCM, 2048 kbps are carried on a single wire sequentially. That is, all the bits of the various time slots, so 32 time slots, follow one another. So here in the incoming, each PCM you will have 2048 kilobits, one after the other. That is, starting from TS0 to TS31. First 8 bits of TS0, next 8 bits of TS1, then TS3 8 bits, and so on up to TS31 8 bits. They will come in serial. Okay. The single wire stream of bits, when fed to serial to parallel converter, it is converted into 8 wire parallel output. So when you are giving this input of 2048 kbps on a single wire to a serial to parallel converter, this one is the serial to parallel, this block. So the data will be available in the output on 8 wires in a parallel mode. Further, we will continue our discussion about this practical switch. For example, all 8 bits corresponding to TS3 serial input are available simultaneously on 8 output wires, 1 bit on each output wire during just 1 bit period of 0.488 microseconds or 488 nanoseconds. So this is nothing but 3.9 microseconds by 8 bits, as shown in the figure. So here, in a time slot duration is equal to 3.9 microseconds. So since in the output we are getting the bits parallelly on 8 wires, the time required for output is only 1/8 of the time slots, because all the 8 bits are available at the same time. The duration required for this is the duration for a bit. The duration for a bit is equal to 3.9 by 8 microseconds, which is 488 nanoseconds or 0.488 microseconds. The parallel output on 8 wires is fed to the switching matrix. So this parallel output, whatever we are getting from the serial input, it is fed to the switching network, switching matrix. It can be seen that during one full time slot period, that is 8.9 microseconds, only one bit is carried on the each output line, whereas 8 bits are carried on the input line during this period. If you can consider one time slot period, that is 3.9 microseconds, so it occupies 8.9 microseconds in the serial input, whereas in the output, which is in parallel form, so the time is required only 0.488 microseconds. Only one bit is carried on the output line. So in the output line, instead of 8 wires, since we are having 8 wires, on each wire, one bit is appearing. You see the TS3, one bit only, on 8 wires it's available. But whereas in the input, on wire, one wire, 8 bits are serially available from bit 1 to bit 8. Therefore, the bit rate on individual output wires is reduced to 1/8 of the input bit rate, that is equal to 2048 by 8, 256 kbps. Because 8 parallel paths, since we have 8 parallel paths, the bit rate in the output is 1/8 of the incoming bit rate. Incoming bit rate is 2048 for PCM. Since in the outgoing you have 4 wires and each wire is carrying one bit of a time slot, so the bit rate is 1/8 of 2048, which is equal to 256 kilobits per second. So we are able to reduce the bit rates from 2048 to 256. So same thing depicted here in this drawing. The input is 2048 kilobits per second. We are feeding this information to serial input to parallel output, that is serial to parallel converter, SIPO. So the output bit rate is equal to 256 kilobits per second. Further, we will continue our discussion on the practical space switch. Due to reduced bit rate in parallel mode, the cross point is required to be operated only for 1/8 of the time required for serial working. It is very simple. So here the cross point is to be operated only for 1/8 of the time when compared to serial mode. Therefore, the cross point can be shared by 8 times more channels, that is 32 × 8, 256 channels in the same frame. So since the cross point operational period is reduced to 1/8 of the incoming signal since you are adopting the parallel switching, so in a 32 time slots or 30 channel PCM, instead of accommodating 32 channels, you will be able to accommodate 32 × 8 = 256 channels in the same frame duration of 125 microseconds because of the serial to parallel conversion, which is equal to 1:8. However, since the 8 bits of the time slot are carried on 8 wires, each cross point must have 8 switches to interconnect 8 input wires to 8 output wires. Here we are talking about the switches requirements. So the input is serial input that we are feeding to serial to parallel converter. Then we are reducing the bit rate from 2048 to 256. But you have the output of the SIPO is of 8 wires. That means you require at each cross point, you require 8 switches because the information is coming on 8 wires. For each wire, one switch is required. We have to understand the cross point should have 8 switches in parallel mode of operation. Each cross point, all the 8 switches will remain operated now for the duration of 1 bit only. That is only for 488 nanoseconds, which is 1/8 of the time slot period, that is 3.9 microseconds. So all the 8 switches should be operated simultaneously during a time slot, and the duration required for each of these 8 switches is 1/8 of the time slot duration, that is equal to 488 nanoseconds. Then here one example they have given so that we can better appreciate the practical switch, space switch. For example, to connect 40 PCM incoming highways, a matrix of 40 × 40, that is equal to 1600 cross points, each having a single switch, is required in serial mode of working. So here they have taken one example. The switch is having 40 incoming PCM highways and also 40 outgoing PCM highways. So we do require a switching matrix of 40 × 40, 40 × 40. That is equal to, you require 1600 cross points. Okay, in serial mode of working. Now we will come to the parallel mode of working. Whereas in parallel mode of working, a matrix of 40 × 8, because we are increasing the efficiency by 8 times. So 40 × 8 × 40 × 8, which works out to be 5 × 5. 25 cross points is sufficient. Okay, instead of 1600, so 25 cross points are sufficient because of converting into 8 parallel outputs. But practically it is not so. Here the information is given like this: since 8 switches are required at each cross point, so here in parallel mode, each cross point requires 8 switches. So now we will compute the requirement of the switches. Cross points are 25. Each cross point should have 8 switches. Therefore, total switches required is equal to 200. 25 × 8 are required. So this much advantage we are able to derive. So instead of having 1600 cross points with single switch, in parallel mode of working, you can have only 200 switches. That is 8 times the switching elements requirement is reduced. Sum up, thus there is a reduction of the matrix by 1/8 in parallel mode working, and hence reduction in size and cost of the switching matrix. Since you are able to reduce from 1600 switches to 200 switches, so you are achieving the efficiency in reduction of size to 1/8. Therefore, the cost of this switch also will come down, since the switches requirement has come down to 1/8 of the total requirement in serial working. So the number of switches has come down by 1/8 times. Therefore, the switching matrix cost also reduced. Now, having understood about the space switch or switching in telecom network, we will proceed to discuss about the principle of the second type of the switch, that is time switch. A digital time switch consists of two memories. This speech or buffer memory, you may call it as speech memory or buffer memory, to store the samples till the destination time slots arrive, and a control or connection or address memory to control the writing and reading of the samples in the buffer memory and directing them onto the appropriate time slots. So in time switch, we should have two memories. This is the memory one, this is the second memory. This memory is known as buffer bar speech memory. The purpose of this memory is to store the information that is coming from the incoming PCM highway. Then you are having another memory, second memory, for the purpose of control. You can call it control or connection or address memory. So this is for writing and reading. That means this will control where the incoming signal information is to be written in the speech memory, and from where the information is to be read out to the outgoing PCM is also available in the control memory. The control memory controls the writing of the information in speech memory as well as reading out of the information from the speech memory to the outgoing PCM highway. Speech memory has as many storage locations as the number of time slots in the input PCM, that is 32 locations for a 30 channel PCM system. So in speech memory, you are having 32 locations. So the because it is a 30 channel PCM with 32 time slots, the information of the time slots is stored in the speech memory in the sequence of time slots. Of course, they are not shown zero, because that is zero also they should have shown. That is actually used for this framing purpose. So like this. So TS4, the information is coming in TS4. So the contents of the TS4 are written in the speech memory in the fourth location. Okay. The writing or reading operations in the speech memory are controlled by the control memory. So, where to be written? The information from these time slots are to be written in the speech memory. Where it is to be written? From where it is to be read out to the outgoing PCM is controlled by this control memory location. This control memory also is having the same number of locations as we have in the speech memory. The number of locations in a 30-channel PCM is 32 in the speech memory as well as 32 in the control memory. Further, we will continue our discussion on the principle of time switch. Each control memory location contains the address of one of the speech memory locations where the channel sample is either written or read during time slot. The addresses are written in the control memory of the central control of the exchange depending upon the connection objective. So each control memory location contains the address of the speech memory location. So this control memory contains the information about the speech memory, where the information is to be written and from where the information is to be read out towards the outgoing PCM. A time slot counter, which usually is a synchronous binary counter, is used to count the time slots from 0 to 31 as they occur. So we should exactly count the time slots. So it should be synchronous. Everything should be on the same time slot. So there is a time slot counter which counts from 0 to 31. All the 32 time slots, it will count serially 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on up to 31 as they occur. When the time slot 0 is coming, so it will count as 0. Time slot 2 is 1 is coming, it is counted as 1 and so on up to 31. At the end of the each frame, it gets reset and the counting starts again. Okay, after one sequence of reading all the 32 time slots, so this counter is reset and once again it starts counting from 0 to 31. It is used to control the timing for writing and reading of the samples in the speech memory. So the purpose of this counter is to control the timing when it is to be written in the speech memory, when it is to be read out from the speech memory towards the outgoing PCM for transfer of information from incoming PCM to outgoing PCM. Now, we will see one illustration for better understanding about the time switch. Consider the objective of that TS4 of incoming PCM is to be connected to TS6 of the outgoing PCM. Here our objective is to transfer the information of TS4 to TS6, or rather to say we have to connect the TS4 of incoming PCM highway to the TS6 of outgoing PCM highway. This is our main motto or objective. In other words, the sample arriving in time slot 4 on the incoming PCM has to be delayed by 6 minus 4, that is 2 time slots, till the destination time slot, that is TS6, appears in the outgoing PCM. So it is very simple, the information. So the information is coming in time slot 4, which is to be sent on time slot 6 on the outgoing PCM. So the reading should be delayed by how many time slots period? So it is coming in 4. So it is to be read out into TS6. That means you have to halt 2 time slots period. So from 4, 5 we have to wait. Then when 6 comes only, it is to be read out into the outgoing PCM. That means the outgoing time slot number is 6 and the incoming time slot number is 4. So there is a difference of 2 time slots period for writing and reading to outgoing PCM. The required delay is given to the samples by storing it in the speech memory. So whatever the delay here we are in this example we are considering is given by utilizing the or by storing the contents of the time slot in the buffer bar speech memory. The incoming PCM samples are written cyclically, that is sequentially, time slot wise in the speech memory locations. Thus, the sample TS4 will be written in the location 4 as shown in the figure. So here the incoming signal from time slot wise is written in the speech memory time slot wise. So first time slot in the first time slot from the first location, second time slot in the second location, like this. This is the time slot 4. In the fourth location, we are writing the contents of the TS4 so that it can be read out as per the central control direction, that is as per the address memory or the control memory or the connection memory. The reading of the sample when it is to be read out to the output is controlled by the control memory. So when this information in TS4 or memory location 4, this is memory location 4, is to be read out into the outgoing PCM time slot, is controlled by this control memory. The control memory location corresponding to output time slot TS6 is 6. So here our objective is we have to send this information to TS6. So the control information, this is the 6th one, central control memory location 6. It gives information from where the information is to be read out to time slot, outgoing time slot. Since it is the time slot 6, so in the memory location 6, the information will be available. Here, if you can see, in the 6th location, it is written as 4. That means you take the information available in the memory speech memory location 4 to the outgoing PCM highway in time slot 6. This is the direction it gets. Since it is the time slot 6, into which we have to send the information from the speech memory, this control memory location 6 refers you, please copy the information from speech memory location 4 into your time slot 6. These contents give the read address for the speech memory. That is, it indicates the speech memory locations from which the sample is to be read out during the read cycle. The sample of TS4 is to be read out into the outgoing PCM as per the directions. So here it directs you take the information from memory location 4 in the read cycle. First is write cycle, incoming information. So when we are sending to outgoing PCM, it is known as read cycle, from where the information is to be read out. Further we will continue. When the time slot TS6 arrives, the control memory location 6 is read. So when TS6 arrives, so this information is read out, control memory location 6. Its content address points to location 4 of the speech memory in the read mode, and the sample is read out, read onto the outgoing PCM. So here, what is written? You please take the information available in 4th speech memory location and read into the outgoing PCM, that too into time slot 7. Control location 6 directs to read the information from location 4 of speech memory. This is the summary. So control memory 6 directs to read the information from location 4 of speech memory into time slot 6. In every frame, whenever time slot 4 comes, a new sample will be written in the location 4. This will be read when TS6 occurs. This process is repeated till the call loss. As long as call in progress, so the information is written from the time slot 4 to the speech memory in location 4, and as per the directive of the control memory, so it is read into the outgoing PCM in the time slot 6. This goes on as long as the conversation is in progress. After call, conversation is over, it is completed, so the call is to be disconnected. The switching arrangement between calling and called party should be isolated. For disconnection of the call, the central control erases the contents of the control memory location to halt further transfer of the samples. This is the call process in time switch. Just like in space switch, here also the central control arranges the information available here so that the transfer process from TS4 to TS6 is halted. So the call is completed. Both calling and call party are freed up for further any call either to make or to receive. This is the process as far as the time switch is concerned. So this is in about the part 2 of digital or digital switch. So we have continued our discussion on space switching, and we have also seen some salient aspects of time switching also. With this, we will conclude this part. Thank you for your participation and listening to viewing this video.